Well, building some financial freedom certainly doesn't take a couple of days, so we're actually going to spend the next 5 weeks going over some tips to help you put together the right plan for you and your family. The Investors Group, Nathan Giesbrick, rejoins us this morning with Smart Money. Good morning. How are things?
Good morning, Rob.
Did you pick New England or the Giants?
I was going for the Giants.
Oh, you rascal. You could have made some money yesterday. building the financial plan. So obviously it's something that we all need before we get ready to retire. So what are the nuts and bolts with piecing one together?
Yeah, putting together a financial plan really requires a number of different components, and we call ours the four cornerstone philosophy. So think of it like a table with four legs. A table can stand with three legs, but if you lean really heavy on one corner, this whole thing can come crumbling down. And so the idea behind this is we want to make sure that the plan that we create for people is going to last them their entire lifetime. So the four components that we're dealing with, the first one most people are aware of is the long-term block. That's the RSPs, the pensions, your LIRAs, your retirement savings component. But what about the other three? The three that really should be in there is your first one is your short-term reserve. So that's money that you set aside for emergencies or opportunities.
The rainy day fund.
The rainy day fund, absolutely. And trust me, they come in handy quite often. The second block, this is to protect you for the unexpected, the income and asset protection. So in the event that you get sick or hurt or premature death, your financial plan will still sustain itself.
And nice to know, life insurance could be part of that component. It's nice to know that you have that fund there. If you happen to go early, at least your family could be covered off as far as a mortgage goes or something like that.
Absolutely. A lot of people aren't aware that the number one cause for bankruptcy in Canada for the last 30 years in a row has been disability. So, you know, we often think, well, if I lose my job, then that's when financial challenges can arise. Yes, that can happen, but what about disability? What about an illness? What about an injury that we're not expecting? So making sure that you're protecting your financial plan and your financial assets long-term. The third block, I like to call this my fun money. This is the moderate-term goal money. So maybe a 3 to 5 year goals, maybe a little bit longer for some, but maybe you're looking to purchase a home, you want to do some traveling with the family, maybe you want to buy a toy of some sort, an RV or a boat. As I said earlier in the weeks, you want to pay cash for those things. Those are wants, not needs. So you're not borrowing money to buy an RV or to take a trip, you're paying cash for them and saving that money up.
So your four pillars: short-term reserve, income and asset protection, moderate-term goals, and longer-term goals. We've got about 30 seconds left. When you come in next Monday, we're going to delve into the short-term reserve and what you need to do to get that rainy day fund started, I guess, if you haven't already.
How do you set it up? You know, where do you go? What kind of investments should you be looking at? You want to make sure that you pick the right ones. Obviously, we want to make sure that the market volatility isn't affecting your rainy day account for when you absolutely need it.
Good stuff. Nathan Giesbrick is our smart money expert. You can learn more all about him and his tips that are very useful. CTVEdmonton.ca, and click on the CTV Morning Live link. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks, Rob.
Smart Money brought to you by Investors Group. Let us help you provide for the people you care about now and over time.